Started our journey today at the Narrows, so named because this is the narrowest part of the Dardanelles Straits. And if Kat swings the camera around there, you can see just how close the other side of the straits are. It's only maybe 2 or 3 kilometres at most over to there. This is probably one of the busiest waterways in the world and has been for hundreds of years. British, Russian, French, Middle Eastern troops and supplies and cargoes and trade have been coming through this region for millennia. And this makes this little bit of water here one of the most valuable bits of real estate in the world. And today, Turkey still fears Russian aggression potentially, or any sort of international aggression or proprietorship or ownership over this area. So the Turkish people know that they have a very valuable piece of land here. So in 1915, as the Turkish government started to create an alliance with the German government, German advisors started coming in here and helping the Turkish military build forts and gun emplacements across both sides of the shore, that side and this side. We're actually standing in the spot where one of the forts that received something like 700 British or French shells on the 18th of March 1915. Now the 18th of March 1915 is a significant date because that's the date that about a month prior to the Anzac landings, the British and the French tried to send their navies up from the south into this narrow bit of water here, which had been heavily mined and with huge gun emplacements on each side. And in a day's battle, some 3 or 4 major French and British battleships were sunk immediately by either hitting mines or through cannon fire, mostly through mines. They eventually retreated, some as they did a U-turn and tried to retreat back down the straits, hit minefields on the sides of the straits, and there were many hundreds of losses. I know one British ship sunk within about 2 or 3 minutes with 800 sailors dead immediately, drowned or lost immediately. All along this place were Turkish gunners busily shooting and being fired upon with shooting cannon fire. Behind us is the collective mass grave of I think only about 18 or 20 Turkish soldiers who died on that day for the loss of, in exchange for the hundreds of British and French sailors or seamen who died as well. But this is where it all started. And when that naval attack failed, that's when the Allied planners started to think about conquering this bit of land through a seaborne invasion, through a landing of troops.